And why don't we speak with the one and only Sid Canu, who just happened to be the one guy that got through?
Oh, yeah. Sid Canu is back. How you doing, John?
You are amazingly entertaining. You really are, as a matter of fact.
Now, to clear up this stuff, we need to be very honest. There is no Khazarian DNA. This book makes it very clear, The Jews of Khazaria. This is a book that you should read to clarify your mind upon this whole thing about the Khazarians, which is used by the Sabbatean Frankists to deflect their attention towards the real problem, which is them. This book clarifies the fact that there is no DNA of the Jews of Khazaria. So the fact that you don't have DNA means that you can't really call somebody a Khazarian. It would be like, at that point, just call him Nazi or communist or whatever.
We really are the ancient people, the Jewish people of today. We really are the ancient people from before. And the Fuentes of the world, and they like to confide it. They like to tell everybody that we are the like the Ashkenazim are actually the Khuzarians. And the reason why they take shots at the Ashkenazim is because really us Ashkenazim, we're like really, really ancient blood. We, the Ashkenazi communities, plus we have all the books too. And Catholics, they love taking our books.
Complex subject. I hope I can clear it, especially because it is unfortunately used for a whole lot of anti-Semitism. The Kingdom of Khazaria lasted more or less 5 centuries. It lasted 5 centuries. It was basically active between the 7th to the 11th century, more or less. And then, of course, there is a lot of talk about the Khazarians also as the ancestors of the Ashkenazi Jews. But all this today, as you will see, is it's actually disinformation. There's a lot of disinformation, and I'm quite surprised that even some Jews have helped within the spread of this disinformation. Today, we need to definitely clear up this matter about this kingdom, which embraced to some extent Judaism and was not Jewish. So for many centuries, a lot of people thought this was just a tale or a legend, but it was actually a real thing. So the Khuzari is considered one of the most important works of Jewish apologetic and has been reprinted many times in several languages. And it offers basically the first insight in why they embrace Judaism in this far distant land, which was a little bit squashed between the rise of the Muslims that they opposed very much. But one good thing about the Khazarians that can be said is that thanks to them, we have basically Eastern Europe clear of the Muslim faith, because the Muslims were advancing and the Khazarians, of course, stopped them. There has always been this fixation regarding the fact that they were the ones who were the originators of a large part of the Jewish population. This is, of course, the fake news that we're still trying to fight after all these years, especially the Khazar hypothesis of the Ashkenazi ancestry. This was a population that basically was practicing various religions. It was actually practicing shamanism.
Yes,
shamanism was shamanism. And then at one point they simply decided, at least because it was a kingdom, so the royal family and all the aristocracy involved with them decided to embrace the Jewish faith. And this was done though without being Jewish. So what they did was they embraced all the various Jewish laws, and of course what happened after that?
But they were not fully Jews, as
they were not Jews at all. The thing is, here we're talking about ethnicity. Ethnicity is not an hypothesis, it's not a religion. The Khazar hypothesis of Ashkenazi ancestry, like I said, is a bit of the problem that we will have to discuss today. But basically, the medieval sources that this hypothesis draws from is are known as the Khazar correspondence, which was basically a set of documents that date between the 1950s to the 1960s after Christ, and they are letters between a guy called Ashdai ibn Shabrui, who was foreign secretary to the Caliph of Cordoba, and the representative of the Khazars, who was a guy called Joseph Kagan. And
Joseph
the correspondence
Kagan, yeah.
of these documents, it gives us an account, of course, of the Khazar conversion to Judaism and its progress into subsequent generations of people who have embraced the Jewish faith, until the fall of the Khazar Empire, which, of course, will last another couple of centuries, but starts to, let's say, the official fall of the Khazar Empire is dated 969 after Christ. So there was a discovery in Crimea, which is a contested land, as you know, because a lot of what we will be discussing about the Khazars today comes from Ukraine, of course. In Crimea, which is, as you know, at the moment a very contested land between Ukraine and Russia, they found some coins which portrayed the symbols of Judaism, but on one side also the symbols of Turkish nomadic tribes that eventually became the people involved in this Khazarian kingdom. So the Khazarians were never Jews. They were Turkish nomadic tribes who at one point made simply a decision, because they were a bit squashed between different powers, and they decided to embrace for the control of, of the religious system, the religious faith. However, a lot of people, of course, converted even amongst the poorer classes, but not the entire population. And there was never an obligation to force them. One of the books which I suggest, a more recent edition of this book, actually is better because it's the third edition, The Jews of Khazaria, Kevin Allen Brock. Now, this book in particular gives us a real understanding about a lot of the problems that we have in this misconception. However, it gives us also all the genetic data that demonstrates that there was never, after a careful study of the genetic data, they saw that the modern Ashkenazi don't have any of the common DNA traces that we find in the Khazarians. So, I mean, it's this whole thing of claiming that the Khazarians were in some way the ancestors of the Ashkenazi and of most of the Jewish population of Eastern Europe is false, also because the Ashkenazi are a minority within Judaism. 80% of the Jews of the world, so 12 to 30 million Jews, descend from 400 families, more or less. Having said this, the Khazars themselves, like I said, were a population that simply embraced the Jewish religion. But there is a lot, of course, of controversy, because a Jewish rabbi who was called Isaac Bayer Levinson, who was born in 1788 and died in 1860, who was born in Ukraine, he launched this this possible connection between the Ashkenazi Jews and the Khazarians. So he was the one who started this connection. Then we find also in the late 19th century another important author, researcher, Ernest Renan, and other scholars who speculated that the Ashkenazi Jews of Europe originated amongst the Turkish, the Turkic refugees who had migrated Turkic, because not properly only from Turkey, but also from other areas like Turkmenistan, for example, who had migrated from the collapsed Khazarian Khanate westwards into Europe. Now, this whole conspiracy theory that is surfacing now mainly comes from one author, though, which is a guy called Arthur Koester, Kessler wrote a book which was published in 1976, known as, this book was entitled The 13th Tribe. Now, the 13th Tribe picked up on the Khazarian theory, which had been floating around Central Europe for quite some time. And Kessler, this guy, I mean, he actually was a Hungarian-born author and journalist who had, by the way, joined earlier on the Communist Party in Germany. Then at the end of the 1930s, he became disillusioned with Stalinism. He eventually moved to Great Britain. He will work for the British Secret Service, for the British intelligence, but he kind of wanted, in a way, to launch this this whole theory, almost to want to help the Jews, but in reality create a whole line of anti-Semitism, because what happened here is this: the Khazarian theory was spread mostly to favor the Palestinians and favored it gave a theory that the Palestinians could use also to their advantage, because of course any future of course was also put into question when you say that these Jews were not really Jews that have been ever living there, but were actually Khazarians. It kind of helped, you understand, help the Palestinian case to say that they should. The thing is with Kessler and with what he was trying to do, it's a little bit weird, because I've been talking with some of my Jewish friends about it, and they told me that basically he was, you know, the fact that he was trying to prove that today Ashkenazi were descended from the Khazars, he thought that it would remove some way anti-Semitism. In reality, it helped anti-Semitism even more. Mm-hmm. There was a guy called Morris Fishberg, and Morris Fishberg was actually also born in Ukraine. And in 1911, he published a book about the Jews, a study into the race and the Jews, and a study of race and environment. And he was also somebody who tried to push this erroneous concept, and that of course there was somehow the Jews were originating, the majority of Jews, from the Khazars. This book that I showed you earlier is interesting, but there is also another book by the same author, which is called The Maternal Genetic Lineages of Ashkenazi Jews, which is of course done with the most modern focuses on the 129 material haplogroups. It's focused basically on the most modern approach that these historians now have, basing themselves on automorphic DNA studies. And with these studies, you can really get to debunk a lot of lies. Jews are a glorious mix of Israelite and local blood from diaspora lands. This is a more, let's say, a more clear description. They are, you know, there is Jewish, of course, DNA. I'm myself partly Ashkenazi Jew, so I can tell that. I mean, I did a DNA test and it comes up, so it's like clearly. When instead, when eventually, and here in this particular book, he says, historians have debated the question of a Khazar component in modern Ashkenazi Jewry for two centuries. He said, you know, that the Russian Jews came from the Volga River Valley of Khazaria. In the 20th century, then, of course, we have also Arthur Kessler, which is talked about. But now that you have geneticists that are actually working on researching all this, They found that the Ashkenazim are not genetically related at all closely to the Turkic-speaking Chuvash and Tatar peoples of the Volga region, nor to North Caucasian peoples. Their study sampled DJ Balkars, Chechens, Kadrin, Kumis, Legends, Noxain, North Ossetians, Tabarasans. So this is a very in-depth study that is being done. And that's why we need to debunk the lies you see that are continuously said. We can't continue to confuse people. Mm-hmm. So sometimes we need to debunk this Khazarian nonsense. I think it's very important that in the year 922 after Christ, the Arabic writer Ahmed ibn Faldran was traveling in the Khazarian kingdom and wrote his impression and experiences. He mm-hmm. definitely confirmed that the king was Jewish, but he still said that Jewish represented a minority in the kingdom. Now, most Khazarians are Muslims or Christians, he said. There was also evidence of very un-Jewish practices, and there is also studies that show that there was a lot of paganism still, and actually in this book there's a whole discussion regarding the shamanic practices here of the Tengri shamanism within the Khazarian Empire. Mm-hmm. And what kind of practices the early Khazars routinely sought the advice of a shaman or medicine man called the Kam in Turkic. A shaman will enter a trance-like state in an attempt to contact the invisible spirit world, to exorcise evil spirit under the earth's surface, and to win the protection of benevolent spirits. Shamans were considered to be both healers and predictors of future events. So they were very much also the Khazars into an elaborate assemblage of gods similar to that of Bulgars or other Turkic tribes. But like we said, at one point they made a decision, and they decided to, at least the guiding elite of the country decided to convert to Judaism. At that point, they of course also invited the Jews from around the world to join them. And for that reason, of course, some Jewish blood entered within the Khazarian Empire, for sure. You have you have Roman Jews, for example, which are very ancient. I mean, the Roman Jewish enclave is one of the oldest one in the world. Mm-hmm. The world. So now, the thing is this, the Khazar thesis is crucial for those people who want to view the Jews are not descendants from ancient Israelites. And they claim that the many blonde, blue-eyed people among the Ashkenazi, in particular, can support this claim. No, but that's why the serious studies on the on this whole topic have demonstrated that the Ashkenazi have nothing to do with the Khazars, because the Khazars are Turkic. So they are of course more dark. Some descendants of the modern Khazars in Hungary. In Hungary, at times you have dark people that are not so Slavic looking, for example. You have the Khazars in Transylvania, you have the Khazars in Lithuania, you have the Khazars in Belarus. You have of course the Khazars, like I said earlier, also you have the Khazars in Poland. And so you have the Khazars also in Ukraine, because the Khazars lived in Ukraine beginning with the westward expansion of the Khazar empire.
Empire,
In what is the Dnipro Valley. And by the middle of the 10th century, a substantial community of Jews, possibly partly Khazarian, lived in the city of Kiev. But in Kiev, you have also Jews that came that were real Jews. Not that I'm saying that the Khazarians are not real Jews, but they are not. Where are the mountain Jews based? The mountain Jews are based in the eastern and northern Caucasus, mainly Azerbaijan, part of what, Chechnya, Ingushetia, Dagestan, And those people, you know, in those countries, you have people who are pretty dark. The Mountain Jews are descendants of Persian Jews from Iran. And some people have claimed that they were also descendants of the Khazarians. But also that is a little bit, the Mountain Jews are distinct, for example, from Georgian Jews, or which are also a little bit. So when you go into all this search, you know, it's very complex. It's not an easy thing, guys, because this is about defining the origins of these people and also the lies that are, you know, that are said. Their thesis, like I said, serves only the purpose to say that these people are not from Israel, and so basically they have no business in getting back and building back Israel after mm-hmm. the Second World War. This is the fundamentally why they are spreading this lie. Everything mm-hmm. else is propaganda. It's basically, if you know, they say these people descend from the Khazars, they were never really Israelites, they were just converts to Judaism, and then they spread their power and tentacles and they're taking over the world. This is what they're claiming. Is first of all, their claim comes from the big lie that the Ashkenazi Jews descend from Khazar. So here we have to go back to the DNA studies, because here then we can really demystify and debunk this whole thing. Now, in 2013, a definitive study done on the genetics by professional genetic teams, if Ashkenazim had been descendants from converted Khazars or Alans, they would have had noteworthy identical by descent sharing some of this population. In reality, they have only extremely low identical by descent sharing from ancestors who lived in very ancient times, well before the Khazarian era. As we know now, uniparental DNA, which is Y-DNA and mtDNA, that's in short, does not show any Ashkenazi Khazar connection either. Hypothesis that the Ashkenazi varieties of the Y-DNA haplogroups, because the haplogroup also is very important to define your origin, mm-hmm. Is fundamental, I would say. Q and R and RI, I could have the case basically have this whole thing has been invalidated, which leaves no Y-DNA haplogroups in the Ashkenazi population that could have come directly from Central or East Asia via male Khazarian ancestors. So you see, here is completely debunked this whole thing. Once we go into the genetics of it, there can't be any supposition, any theory, any speculation. Then mm-hmm. it's science that, you know, through a methodology that is very accurate. I mean, I'm sure that a lot of people, you know, will have some problems if we were not relating completely to science. But in this case, it's very important to relate to science. Why? Because the Ashkenazim do not descend from any of the lineages of Khazar men, whether royal, noble, or common. Mm-hmm. The Ashkenazi mtDNA. Haplogroups of East Asian origin do not support a narrative of Khazarian heritage. The most likely explanation for their existence among Ashkenazi is medieval intermarriage between traveling Ashkenazi merchants and Chinese women. Most Ashkenazi and Ashkenazi Levites, which descend and originate from, for example, the Middle East, likely Persia, for example, mm-hmm. proportional Sephardim, along with the Ashkenazi branch also that have this kind of descendant. But the Khazarian element is being debunked now. So I think it's very important to understand.
We have debunked this. We have debunked this.
Well, no, it seems like the Ashkenazi gradually got absorbed in the populations of the land where they were living in. It doesn't seem like they went around the world to conquer anything, really.
No.
No genetic evidence that the mountain Jews descend from the Khazars. That's another thing that we have today, at least for all our viewers, explained very well that the migration of German Jews into Eastern Europe, for example, the English-speaking Ashkenazi Jews from Germany and Austria, don't have anything with the Khazar.
There is no an Ashkenazi conspiracy coming from Khazar, from the Kingdom of Khazaria people.
People like Henry Kissinger is a Sabbatian Frankist, and this has been recognized by Randy, Rabbi Anterman, who even did a ritual to excommunicate him. And these are things that have been fought for the last two centuries within Judaism. This heresy, actually, for over 2.5 centuries, this heresy has been present, and the Frankists need to be fought, but nobody gives them, everybody's focusing on the Khazarian, because the Khazarian fit Sabbatean and Jesuits and all the work that we are trying to do here is to debunk also this Arthur Koestler. Some people say he might have wanted to help the Jews by spreading these lies within present in his book, The 13 Tribe, but he actually harmed a lot of people by doing this. And today we see it with all the hate that we go in all these alternative sites, the hate that they are pushing against Jews every day, accusing Khazarians, you are not really Israel.
Sid's cool. Got a good heart. He's a good guy. I like talking to him.